Good morning, everybody. Come on, let's all join in. Let's get ready for worship. Let's get ready for worship. We are excited to be here this morning. Amen. This is definitely the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. And so we just want to join in with the worship as it's playing. While we are enjoying the worship, we're asking that you'll go ahead and share this live video. Don't set up watch parties, but just share it so that we can draw the whole entire audience back to our Purpose Church page. So at this time, go ahead and share the video. Once you've shared the video, make sure everyone in your house is up, ready for worship, because there's something that God wants to speak over the people today, and we want everyone to be able to receive what God has to say. So at this time, we're just going to keep worshiping God. We're going to allow everyone to get in and gather themselves and get ready for worship. Amen. Amen. Come on. If you don't see anybody in this comment section that's a Purpose member or a family or friend that you know need a word from God, tag them now. Tag them, text them, wake them up, say, hey, it's time for church. We got to get on live now so that we can be able to receive God, receive what he has to say to us. I believe that today God has something special, custom made for you on today, something that's going to impact your heart and encourage your spirit. And so we want everybody to be live. We want everybody to be ready for worship. Amen. We don't want you just to come in and kind of watch what's going on, but get involved. Amen. However you used to respond to the word of God in the church building, you should be responding the same way at home. Amen. Let's make the devil mad today. Amen, because I just believe that God has something exciting for us. Amen, I am just excited, as you can see this morning. I'm excited about what God is getting ready to do. Amen, so just a few more seconds of worship. If you don't mind, this is one of my best worship songs that I drive to work with, and I just allow God to minister to me through this song. And so if you don't mind, if we can just listen to it for a few more seconds, and then I'll begin with prayer. Amen. We shall never be defeated, because God is the greatest power. We will never, ever be defeated. I don't care what anybody says. I don't care what the enemy is saying. We will not be defeated. Amen. Hallelujah. I need y'all to declare this in your house. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Come on, you said the devil is a liar. God be exalted. Hey, never be defeated. Never be defeated. I need you to declare it as loud as you can in your house. Wake everybody up, the neighbors, everybody, that you will not be defeated in this season. You will not be defeated. Hallelujah. I know that it feels like you're close to it, but the devil, he's definitely a liar. You can't trust him, because God is exalted, and we will never be defeated. Absolutely not. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Keep letting it replay. keep letting it replay. I'm going to send in the comment section later on after this is over with. I'll send it to you so you'll know exactly who this worship leader is. I'm telling you, this song is going to bless your spirit. You just begin to declare what it is saying to you. It's definitely going to be a blessing to you. And so we want to get started with prayer because I'm excited about what the man of God is getting ready to share with us on today. I'm excited about the word. And we, as soon as we finish with this, we're going to switch over to Three Crosses of Calvary's page. It's Pastor Donahue's anniversary. Just because we're not in the building, listen, hear me clearly. Just because we are not in the building does not mean we stop celebrating our men and women of God. We do not stop. We still celebrate our pastors. And so we want to be able to join with Three Crosses. As soon as we're finished with this service, Pastor Hill is preaching for Pastor Donahue's anniversary because we're still going to celebrate our men of God because we're thankful for his leadership and just the time that he has spent in kingdom building business. Amen. And so we're excited about Pastor Donahue and Lady Donahue's day, and we're going to celebrate them as soon as we finish with this. Amen. So as you guys are still worshiping and still gathering, God brought me to this morning. Pastor Hill and I had a heart-to-heart as pastor and executive pastor, and we have come to this agreement that we cannot feel like we're being defeated or frustrated. I'm being transparent with you on this morning. Things don't look like what we thought they should. People are not involved like we thought they should, but we cannot give up. We have to continue with doing the business of God. And I'm sorry, I'm being transparent on this morning, but we, just because we are online does not mean that we get a chance to take a vacation from God's business. We have to be about God's business. And so God directed me right back to something that we started in 2016, something that I created, a confession for our church. And so I'm going to decree and declare that on this morning. If I have time when I finish, I'm going to pray over those that are watching and those that will come on and watch later. I'll do that as well. But God has brought me to this. And so every single Sunday from till God releases it, I'm going to pray this confession for our ministry. And we are going to believe God. And I will also put this into our church page so you guys can have it and confess it as well. Amen. Those of you that have came after 2016 or 17, after we declared this, you may not have a copy of it, but I'll make sure every member has a copy. Amen. Okay, so here we go. Church growth confession. Amen. Father God, we thank you for being the good shepherd of Purpose Church, your house of prayer. We are an inheritance purchased and covered by the blood of Jesus. We are fulfilling your commission to win the lost, make disciples, and establish your kingdom in the earth. Father, by your spirit, we call from the lost, from the north, the south, the east, and the west into this church, and every service is filled and overflowing. We decree that signs, wonders, and miracles confirm your word preached, leading multitudes to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Draw the lost and send angels as reapers to fill God's house. We receive fresh rhema word from heaven in every service to feed your sheep. And we decree that they shall not wander. We pray that you will restore the hearts of individuals who have backslidden, offended, scattered, and are turned away. We call them back into the kingdom, back into your house, back into position, transformed and renewed, and no man shall pluck them out of your hand. Heavenly Father, unite our hearts to care for your flock. We decree that all of you have given us, we have lost none. We reap the harvest and call in laborers for the perfecting of the saints to the edify the body in love. In your name, we keep watch over the souls that are won. We bind up the broken, we love one another, and we mature them in the perfection in Christ. We honor the prophet of this house. We thank you, Lord, for the apostle leadership, prophetic utterance, expansion, evangelistical outreach, effective teaching, and pastoral covering and care. We release the anointing and the grace to win the lost and nurture your flock in Jesus' name. Father in heaven, we thank you, God, now. We thank you for your grace, God. We thank you for your mercy. God, we thank you for keeping us. God, we thank you for covering us. God, we come, God, as we're standing here, oh God, in your presence. God, just honoring you for who you are. God, we honor you, oh God, for just being an amazing God. God, we honor you, oh God, just for being an awesome wonder in our soul. God, we honor you all today because, God, you kept us and you never left us. And so, God, we tell you thank you. We tell you thank you right now in the name of Jesus. Now, God, I pray, oh God, that we get the boost that we need, oh God, to go after your kingdom harder. God, I pray now, God, that we get the boost of energy that we need, oh God, that will begin, oh God, to give us the patience to run this race, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Now, God, we pray, oh God, that there shall be a stirring going on in our spirit in the name of Jesus, that we shall not lose focus, oh God, that we shall not lose entrance, oh God, in kingdom building. But God, every single day, God, we will still go after the lost, oh God. Every single day, God, we will still go after those, oh God, who need to have a place in the kingdom of God. God, I pray, oh God, that you will just give us the things that we stand in need of, oh God. God, I pray, oh God, that you'll give us the tools and the resources, oh God, and the people, oh God, and the disciples that we need, oh God, to run this race, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Now, God, I pray, God, that you'll just begin, oh God, to build up the leaders. In the name of Jesus, oh God, I pray, God, that you'll just begin, oh God, to give them what they need, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I pray covering over their lives, oh God. I pray that nothing is lacking, nothing missing or broken in their homes. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you'll be the supplier of their every need, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I pray for every partner of Purpose Church, oh God, wherever they may be, oh God, draw them nearer, nearer, oh blessed Lord, oh God. Draw them, oh God, closer to your heart. Draw them, oh God, closer to you in the name of Jesus. God, we said thank you, God, for giving us healing and grace. God, we said thank you, oh God, for giving us mercy and blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. God, you did not let us to fall, oh God, in this season. God, you did not let us lack, oh God, in this season, but God, you kept on blessing us. And so, God, with that, oh God, we owe you, oh God. God, we owe you on today. God, let us not forget the things, oh God, you have done for us. God, let us not get lazy and lax, oh God, and forget how you covered us. God, let us not forget about the time, oh God, you saved our lives. God, let us not forget the time, God, you delivered us, oh God, out of the hand of the enemy, oh God. Let us not forget, oh God, the times, oh God, you cleaned us up from addiction. God, let us not forget, oh God, the time, oh God, you snatched us out of the drug house, oh God. Let us not forget, oh God, the time we were laid in the hospital bed, oh God, and you healed our bodies, oh God. Let us not forget, oh God, that when the judge, oh God, slammed down his hammer, oh God, and said guilty, God, you turned it around and said we were not guilty. Let us not forget, oh God, the things that you have done for us, oh God, and not just for us, oh God, but for our people. God, not just for our people, oh God, but for our friends and our coworkers. God, let us not forget your grace. God, let us not forget your love, oh God. Let us not forget, oh God, the way that you have made for us, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, when we remember, we will come running back to you, oh God. When we remember the things that you have done for us, oh God, we will draw closer to your heart, oh God. It wasn't because we were too smart, but God, your grace, it sheltered us and it covered us and it kept us, oh God, from getting coronavirus, oh God. It kept us, oh God, from getting the diseases that floating around, God. It was you. It was not of our own, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we said thank you right now, oh God, for all that you have done for us, oh God, in all the ways, God, you have performed for us, oh God. We come with a thankful heart, oh God, not looking for you to do anything, oh God, but just to say thank you. God, we said thank you on today. Because if it had not been for you, oh God, we said thank you. All today, oh God, we have been adjusting to our new normal, but God, we forgot to go back and say thank you. Since March, oh God, you've kept us. Many of us have not been affected, oh God, and we said thank you. We have not been affected, oh God, by the economy change. God, we said thank you. God, we thank you now, oh God, for just providing for our families. God, we say thank you now, oh God, that when the time was ticking, you showed up in the nick of time, oh God. When everybody else got the pink slips, God, we were able to still clock in every day to work. We said thank you.
Jesus. God, you met every need. You supplied them. And so we tell you thank you now. Now, God, that we remember what you have done. Let us be about your business. Let us be about your business, what you've called us to do. Just like you haven't lacked blessing us, let us not lack serving you. Now, God, we tell you thank you for all the things that you have done. And God, we say thank you for what you're getting ready to do. I believe, oh God, that on today things are going to shift. And I believe that things are going to turn around for the better. So God, we just say we love you and we trust you in this season. Not knowing, oh God, what you're getting ready to do, but God, we trust you. Not knowing where it's going to take us, but God, we trust you. And so we say, thank you, oh God, for covering us. Thank you, oh God, for never leaving us. Even when we walked away, even when we threw our hands up, God, you did not turn your back on us. And we said, thank you. That when we came to ourselves, you were still standing there. Thank you, God, that you have never, ever left us. Now, God, we pray over the man of God that has the responsibility to pastor, oh God, to preach and teach every Sunday morning to a cell phone. God, we pray your covering grace on the man of God that he shall not one moment doubt, oh God, what you are doing in this season. God, we pray for wisdom for the man of God. We pray for vision for the man of God. We pray for rest for the man of God. God, we pray for those that are assigned to the man of God to come forth in the name of Jesus that can assist, oh God, with the journey. God, we said thank you. We believe that it's already done. We believe that it's working out for our good. God, we stand on your word and we stand on your promises that all things work for the good of them that love you and that are called according to your purpose. We stand on your word. We believe by faith that it is already done. In Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you all. We are thankful for what God is getting ready to do on today. We believe by faith that it is already done and that it is going to work out for our good. At this time, we want to bring up our man of God who is going to come and decree and declare the word on this morning. Amen.
Amen. Good morning. Come on, let's give God some praise. Let's magnify God. Let's honor God because he is faithful and he is kind and he is true. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made and we have a responsibility as believers to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. I'm excited about this day. I'm excited how God continues to wake us up and he continues to, bless us just over and over again with the activity of our limbs and breath, fresh air, and all those wonderful things that God continues to do for us and how he just continues to overflood us and overflow us with all joy and all love and all patience and all peace. Everything that is available to us, God continues to do for us, and we just want to tell God thank you. So do me a favor, just tell the Lord thank you. Amen. Come on, just tell the Lord thank you for his grace. Thank you for his mercy. Thank you for his love. Thank you for his kindness. Just tell him thank you, knowing that when we tell God thank you, it makes so much room for so many other things that the Lord wants to do in our lives. And so before we complain about anything or even ask God for anything, we have a responsibility just to lift our voice and tell God thank you. He's kept us 8 months, 8 months in the year, 8 months in the midst of a pandemic. Many of you may not know, this pandemic started way before March. And so he's kept us 8 months of this year in the pandemic. We came into the year, into a pandemic, not even knowing that we were coming into a pandemic in January and even before. And so we need to just tell God, thank you for keeping us all year long in 2020. And guess what? The year is not over. And as I posted on yesterday, I just believe in my heart that we are in the midst of a new beginning. And God is about to do some new things, some exciting things. Things are going to be different. But when we listen, when you learn how to embrace different, you understand that that difference becomes your new norm. Amen. The difference becomes your new norm. And so we just thank God about what he's going to do and what he's going to continue to do in our lives. Listen, do me a favor. As we've been preaching and asking, let's just hit the share button. Hit the share. We have about 30, 40 people who are online. If everybody would just hit this share button, we can boost up our algorithm online because social media really doesn't allow everybody to see your video that's on your page unless somebody shares that video. So you can have 4,000 or 5,000 people who have liked your church page, but it will limit the number that people are able to see. But the moment you hit share, the moment you begin to type and engage and say amen and high five somebody in the comments and talk back to your neighbor, it begins to boost up the algorithm on our social media page. And other people will then begin to see that you're on live watching your church experience and that our church is live online. And so listen, I need more than the 10 people who have already shared this to share our live feed. So let's just jump in and hit share. Share is your way of serving on this morning, serving the body of Christ. I want to say good morning to our entire church family, to our elders, amen, to our deacons, to our mothers of the church. Let's continue to pray for Mother Livingston as God continues to do a work in her life as well. Let's continue to pray for those who are sick, those who have lost loved ones, those who are suffering from any type of levels of affliction on this morning. Let us pray for our brother Chris, who was in a car accident on last night. He and his daughters, but he is at home doing well on this morning. We thank God for covering and keeping his life. We want to say happy birthday to all of the August birthdays. Happy birthday to all the Leos. All the Leos in the house, happy birthday to every last Leo who is in the house. We thank God for you. We thank God for your life and to all the great things that the Lord has done and that the Lord continues to do over and over again. We are so faithful, grateful, and we are so kind for his brand new mercies that we see every single day. Listen, don't forget to give a gift. Be a giver. Don't forget to be a giver. The information is on your screen, and one of our leaders and our finance people can type the information in as well. But you can text to give. You can Zelle, Cash App. You can go to our website, www.perfectchurch.com, and you can give. Listen, we're preparing this month and next month to do some big online outreach stuff. I got some ideas that's brewing in my mind and brewing in our heads. And we're going to be a blessing online to some amazing people. And so it is your giving that allows us to be a blessing to somebody else. It is your giving that allows us to continue to do ministry. It is your giving that allows us to buy the technology and things that we need to even have church online as well. And so we want to encourage every partner of Purpose Church, please be a tither. Please be a giver. And as you know, every month we're finding a way to bless somebody. Last week, we blessed over $1,000 worth of blessings to scholarships and online blessings to people on last week because of your tithes and your offering and your giving. So we said thank you to all of you that do that as well. Then personally, thank you to those who individually who may send personal love offerings to my wife and I and to our family every week or whenever you do so. I want to personally say thank you for what you do outside of the norm. Your pastors, we really, really appreciate that. Amen. Let's jump into the Word of God. Let's jump into the Word of God. As Pastor Pat has shared, after we log off here at 10 o'clock, at 10:30, we're going to go live with Three Crosses of Calvary Church as we celebrate our Father, our Bishop, 26 years in ministry. And so I'm going to ask every Purpose member that once we log off here, that you would just drive on over to Purpose Church. Not Purpose Church, Three Crosses of Calvary. Drive on over. In other words, log off and log on to Three Crosses of Calvary. You'll see it streaming live on your feed somewhere on social media. And just jump in and celebrate with us the man of God for 26 years, not just pastoring Purpose Church, but also, I mean, pastoring Three Cross of Calvary, but also covering Purpose Church and its leaders and pastors as well. Amen. Let's go to Luke chapter number 5, verse number 17. Luke chapter number 5, verses 17 through 26. Luke 5, 17 through 26. Amen. We want to pray for all of our college students who are getting ready to head to college, who have already went to college, and all of those things this month. Let's continue to keep them covered, even in the midst of a pandemic, that they will be in their own little school bubbles and they will be covered and kept safe as well. Luke chapter 5, verse 17 through 26. I'm reading from the NIV version. Amen. And when you got it, just type on the screen, "I got it." Type on the screen, "I got it." When you got the word, just type on the screen that "I got it." Amen. I know many of you are used to going to the Bible on your phone, and you may be in church on your phone, but grab your hardcover Bible and just turn those pages. There's nothing like turning the pages of a book, and go to Luke chapter number 5. The Bible says this: one day Jesus was teaching, and Pharisees and the teachers of the law were sitting there. They had come from every village of Galilee and from Judea and Jerusalem. And the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. Some men came carrying a paralyzed man on a mat and tried to take him into the house to lay him before Jesus. When they could not find a way to do this because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and they lowered him on his mat through the tiles in the middle of the floor, in the middle of the crowd, right down in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." Verse 21. The Pharisees and the teachers of the law began thinking to themselves, "Who is this fellow who speaks blasphemy? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why are you thinking these things in your heart?" Verse 23 says, "Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up and walk'?" Verse 24, Jesus says, "I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." So he said to the paralyzed man, "I tell you, get up, take your mat, and go home." Verse 25 says, "Immediately he stood up in front of them, took what he had been laying on, and went home praising God." Verse 26 says, "Everyone was amazed and gave praise to God. They were filled with awe and said, 'We have seen remarkable things this day.'" And the word of the Lord is blessed. Today we want to continue in our monthly preaching series entitled "The Miracle Worker." The Miracle Worker. Amen. God, we honor you. We thank you for our time together. Bless us to preach and to share your word. Touch someone's heart that they might receive it. Remove every distraction that may try to keep them from and block them from getting the word on today. Bless us and fill us. It is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. As we continue to march through this teaching and preaching series, looking at various stories in the Bible, various biblical stories, talking about the miraculous works of Jesus Christ, how he healed sick, raised dead, caused the blind to see, and all of these things, it reminds us and keeps us in a renewal spirit to understand that God is still working miracles in our lives. Even as we read these stories, it is a refreshing to remind us as believers that these are just not biblical stories. These are not just ancient folk tales or myths that are being preached and talked about. But even in today's time, that which God did back then, God is still able and he's still working miracles. miracles. And if you agree with me, just type on the screen that God is still working miracles. Come on, type it. God is still working miracles. Here it is, we find in this particular text and this particular story that Jesus is still working miracles among those around him who would believe on as he is the Son of God, those who would believe on him. And Jesus, I've discovered, often always takes the faith of others to work miracles for someone else for the purpose that others might believe. Let me say it again. Jesus often always take the faith of others to work miracles for someone else for the purpose that other people might believe. It's a three-part component that Jesus uses when it comes to working miracles: the faith of others, the situation and the faith of the individual, and then the unbelievers, the faith of the unbelievers or the doubt of the unbelievers, so that they might believe that God is God and Jesus is Jesus. And therefore, we all witness miracles either voluntarily or involuntarily. Again, we all witness miracles even voluntary or involuntarily, whether we like it or not, we are somehow associated with a miracle. Amen. In our text, this particular miracle involves some men whom we may assume that they were friends of a paralyzed man. The Bible doesn't really, this particular version of it, and we find this in three different versions in the Bible, in Matthew, also in Mark. But here it is, these men, they must have had to been some type of friends or associate to the man who was paralyzed. And the Bible says that while one day while Jesus was teaching among the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, that they all were sitting there while he was in Galilee, the religious leaders were in the midst of them. And the Bible says in verse number 17, and the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. The Bible says the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. Now, we must remind that this is Luke who is telling the story, and Luke was a great physician. And so everything that he talks about and that he writes about, it often deals around the idea of the humanistic part of people, humanity and healing and the anatomy of people and all of these things related to the physical part of people. And so by natural sense of who Luke is, he's going to often always describe things from a doctor or a physician perspective. And so he's going to highlight healing. He's going to highlight sick. He's going to highlight miracles and all those things from a physician's perspective. And anytime we see something pop up like this early in the text that says that the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick, it will let us know that obviously Jesus is about to heal somebody. If the story starts out like that, you can then understand that Jesus, at any moment in this story, he is going to heal somebody. And let me tell you this morning that when Jesus shows up, get ready, because something is about to happen. Something's going to happen. The Bible says in verse 18, and so these men came carrying this paralyzed man who had his mat, and they get to the house. And there's such a huge crowd in the house that they can't get through the doors because everybody's trying to get to Jesus. Because keep in mind, the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. And so I believe if the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick, that it attracted all type of people who not just wanted to get a word from Jesus because he was teaching, but also to be healed. And the Bible says that these men were desperate to get their friend or their associate who was laying on his bed of affliction in a paralyzed state. They was determined to get him to where Jesus was. And listen, in the midst of your most paralyzing moment in your life, you need some people around you who can carry you. Gonna say it again. When you hit some paralyzing moments in your life where you don't have legs to walk, your legs give out. Has anybody ever been in those situations where life hit you or some bad news hit you and you just can't seem to walk? You need some people in your life who are willing to carry you and to get you to Jesus. You need some people, here it is, who can give legs to your faith. Let me say it again. You need some people around you who can give some legs to your faith when you can't walk to it for yourself. Amen. Sometimes your faith can cause you to want something from Jesus, but your current situation has you paralyzed. And even though you have the faith to get to Jesus, you may not know how you'll be able to move your mat and yourself to Jesus if you can walk. And so you need some people around you who have just enough faith who can help put some legs to your faith to walk you to where you gotta go. The Bible says that these men were so determined that they got up on the roof of the house and they tore the roof off the house to get to Jesus. My brothers and sisters, you need some people in your life who are willing to tear up some stuff on your behalf to get to Jesus. Do I have anybody, any witnesses, anybody who's watching that you know you got some people in your life that when it gets ready to go down, they will tear some stuff up for you, no matter what it is, no matter who it is? Listen, you need some people in your life. You need some straight, some straight thugs or somebody in your life that is willing. They're not too cute, they're not too pretty and all of those things, but they would tear up some roofs and tear some things on your behalf to get you to Jesus. The Bible says that they get up on the roof, they tear up somebody's roof. Didn't care about who roof it was, and lowered Jesus down in the middle of the crowd. Lowered the man down, the paralyzed man, in the middle of the crowd, down in front of Jesus. You need some people around you who will stop at nothing to get you in front of Jesus, to get the healing that you need. Not only do you need people around you, but we need to be the type of friends and people. When people in our lives are struggling, we know they need to be in front of Jesus. That we do what we got to do to pick them up and say, look, come on, I'm going to take you to Jesus. Matter of fact, you're watching right now, and you know some people that may not be watching right now, and you know they need to get to Jesus. You need to tag their name right now in the comment section and put them in front of Jesus. Now, I'm not talking about me as Jesus, but the word that we are presenting. Put them in front of the word of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in verse number 20, when Jesus saw their faith, he said, friend, your sins are forgiven. When Jesus saw their faith, he says to the paralyzed man, friend, your sins are forgiven. I like this particular text because in other versions, it says that Jesus says to him, son, your sins are forgiven. Or man, your sins are forgiven. But this particular text, Luke says, which signifies a personal thing, Jesus says to the man, friend, your sins are forgiven. Sometimes it is the faith of those with you that will get Jesus to do something for you. Say it again. Sometimes it is the faith of those who are around you that Jesus takes notice of that will then get Jesus to do something for you. Jesus was impressed with the faith of all the men and all that they went through just to get this man in front of Jesus. Here it is, here it is. Jesus, he didn't need to know the faith of the man who was paralyzed. Because obviously, if his friends had enough faith in Jesus to get this man to Jesus, would suggest to Jesus that they were not only reacting upon their own faith, but they were attached, they had attached themselves to the faith of their friend. And so Jesus had to understand that if these men had this much faith, then obviously the man that's laying on the mat paralyzed, he had to have enough faith to encourage them to get him to Jesus, that his faith rubbed off on them, and they attached their faith together. They put legs to their faith, and they tore off the roof to get the man to Jesus, right in front of Jesus. And Jesus says he saw their faith and says to the man, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." Your sins are forgiven. Isn't this a strange response from Jesus? This man who's paralyzed, laying on the mat, going through what he's going through. Jesus doesn't say, "Be healed." He doesn't lay his hands on him. He doesn't give him instructions on what to do. Jesus simply tells the man, says to him, "His sins are forgiven." This suggests that whatever his issue was, or whatever it was that paralyzed him and put him in this position, was something he himself did. It would suggest that it was the man, something in his life that caused him to be paralyzed, and he put his own self in this position. How many of you are willing to be real with me this morning? That sometimes some stuff that paralyzes us, it wasn't nobody else's fault. Some things that made us sick, even unto the point of death, it wasn't everybody else's fault. But when we be real about our situation and our position, sometimes it's some stuff that we did. I may lose a whole bunch of viewers this morning. You may log off at this point. Sometimes it's us. It's some stuff that we put ourselves in that causes us to be paralyzed and laying on a mat in any given situation in our lives. Sometimes it's not always everybody else's fault. But it's us who put ourselves in this position. Let me suggest to you that in this season, while we are in the midst of a pandemic, that this is also not just a season to ask God for things, but it's also a season of repentance. In this moment, you should be reflecting over your own life, the issues in your own life, asking God, "Lord, if there's anything that's within me that should not be, forgive me, have mercy, take it away, and strengthen me." Because we soon will discover that many times once we ask and go to God for forgiveness, or God removes some stuff from our lives, here it is, we'll feel a whole lot better. I wish somebody that was with me this morning can testify that when I let some stuff go, when the Bible says the sins that so easily beset us, that we, once we lay it aside, we're able to run this race. Jesus doesn't tell the man he's healed. He says, "Your sins are forgiven." Bible says in verse 21, the religious leaders, the Pharisees, they all begin, y'all still with me? They all begin to think to themselves, who is this man who speaks blasphemy? They say, who can forgive sin but God? Bible says Jesus knew what they were thinking. And so he turns around and asks them, why are you thinking these things in your heart? Which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven or to say get up and walk? Jesus calls them out on what he knew they were thinking in their mind. And because of their limited thinking, they in their mind thought that he was not God and he did not have the authority to forgive this man of his sins. That only God can do that. Matter of fact, they was even willing to see a miracle and Jesus healed him. But then they said, hold up, wait a minute. Now you're going too far. Only God can forgive people of their sins. So he questions and asks him, which one is easier? For me to say your sins are forgiven or to get up and walk. You pick which one that you want. You see, many times we want blessing without the repentance. Many times we want the miracle without the forgiveness. These Pharisees are just saying, listen, you could have just did what you was going to do, but now you're going too far trying to play God and forgive people of their sins. But what is the sense in God miraculously healing us or blessing us only for us to go right back to the same thing that had us paralyzed once before? You see, sometimes we are paralyzed and we're stuck in one place. And God blesses us to get from that place. But then we go right back to the thing because we didn't take time to repent and to be forgiven, to move past the sickness. We go right back to the thing that put us on our mat in the first place or put us on our bed of affliction in the first place. It's just like putting on perfume or cologne or some smell good, but never washing up and cleaning off. When the perfume scent wears off, the funk is still going to be there. Huh. And here it is. If people stick around you long enough, when the sweet stuff smell off, they'll smell the bad stuff. Come on here, somebody. But Jesus says, let me deal with the sin part. And if I forgive you of your sins, it's going to take care of everything else. He said, I had to get to the root of the problem. The Bible says in verse number 24, he says, but I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sin. So here it is. The Bible says, he says to the paralyzed man, I tell you what, get up, take your mat, and go home. You see, my brothers and sisters, here it is. The effects of forgiving sins could not be verified. People looked at the physical, but miracles could be. You see, if Jesus forgave him for his sins, they could verify what the sins were. But if he got up and started walking, they saw the miracle, which could be verified as far as Jesus' power and authority. But then Jesus, he took the harder option. He goes forth, he says, you know what, forget it. He tells this man to stand up and walk. Did you not notice that even after Jesus told the man his sins were forgiven, obviously the man was still laying there, waiting for the validation from the Pharisees and the others who were around him after Jesus had already freed him from his sins? He was still sitting there waiting for everybody
else to say it's okay. And many of us are in the same boat. God has already forgiven you, but you are still laying around paralyzed on your mat waiting for people to say it's okay to get up. Lord, have mercy. We're still waiting after Jesus has already said you are forgiven, because whether we realize it or not, your healing came when he forgave you. Your healing from the situation that had you paralyzed, your last relationship had you paralyzed, but your healing came when Jesus said you are forgiven. But you still lay there paralyzed because you was waiting for the Pharisees in your life. You were waiting for the naysayers and the Sadducees in your life to say, it's okay now, you can get up and walk. Jesus says, no, the moment you're laying there not knowing, you're already healed. So you can get up now, because when Jesus has forgiven you, the miracle was not with the man getting up when Jesus says get up. The miracle was that Jesus had already forgiven him for whatever it was that paralyzed him. And so I'm going to say to you this morning, God has already forgiven you and healed you. Now get up. Take up your mat. As my grandma used to call it, get your little pallet. Get your pallet up off the floor. Get your mat up off the floor of your bed. And go ahead and walk. Come on, somebody shout, get up. Get up. Get up. You're already healed. The miracle has already happened. You're still laying there waiting for everybody else's approval. You don't need anybody else's approval once Jesus says that you are, your sins are forgiven. Bible says immediately he stood up in front of them, took what he had been lying on, and went home and praise God. Bible says everyone was amazed, gave praise to God, they were filled with awe, and said, we have seen remarkable things today. The paralytic man who was stationed on his mat, couldn't move, with total hopelessness. But after being healed, the Bible says he got up. Thank you, Jesus. He took what he had been laying on and went praising God. And that's a word for somebody this morning. Get up, but don't just get up. Take what you've been laying on. Because what he had been laying on was the proof of where he had been. What he had been laying on was the proof and the evidence of what his situation was. Don't just toss it away, but now it becomes your testimony. Donna Lawrence says, I may have some scars, but I'm healed. Circumstances, but I'm still healed. The mat was a proof of his scars. The Bible says, Jesus says, get up, take your mat, and go ahead and praise God. And that's exactly what he did. Everyone in the house and outside the house was amazed. Praised God because of the miracle. And they declare, we have seen a miracle today. I believe we are in a season when us and those who are around us and those who do not believe are about to see some remarkable things. This text shows us the importance of having faith. Not just faith for ourselves, but faith for others. To bring those who are paralyzed in their lives, like this paralytic man, to Jesus. Which then will indicate to us that God honors us when we seek to lead others to Jesus. And in this season and beyond, if we want to see miracles, signs, and wonders, Jesus by faith. If you want to see a miracle, don't just wait. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Don't just wait until you need a miracle. But when you find somebody that needs a miracle, needs healing, needs some help, needs some breakthrough, attach your faith to their faith and help carry them to the miracle worker, the one who can work the miracle. Carry them in prayer. Carry them in praise. Carry them in encouragement. Carry them in worship. Carry them in charity. Get them to Jesus when they can't seem to get there for themselves. Put your legs to their faith and carry them to the miracle worker who can work the miracle in their lives, who has the power and the authority to forgive them, to forgive us all of our sins, so that we then can be healed and take up our bed, take up our mat, take up our situation, and walk and praise God and give God glory, so that all people can see the remarkable thing, the amazing thing that God has done right before their very eyes today. Amen. God bless you. If you're watching and you're just like that man who was paralyzed on that mat, I want you to attach your faith to Purpose Church faith. And when you can't walk, let us help carry you and put you right in front of Jesus, so that your sins might be forgiven and in the process you will be healed and you can get up on your feet, take up your situation, your mat, and go praise God. That's you today, you're watching. Why don't you want to be saved? Why don't you inbox us or just type in a comment, "I want to be saved." If you're watching online, type in the comments, "I want to be saved." And one of our ministers will connect with you, connect their faith to your faith, and we'll get you in front of Jesus through prayer, through repentance, through fellowship into the kingdom of God. Or you may be watching, you're already saved, not a member of a church. You can come partner and connect with Purpose Church. You can simply type in the comment section, "I want to be a part of Purpose. I want to be a part of Purpose." And one of our ministers will connect with you, connect their faith with you, and connect you to be a part of Purpose Church. Amen. Let us pray. Thank you for watching. If you can, so kind, take an opportunity to give. The giving information is on your screen. Let us pray. God, we honor you. We say thank you for our time together. We thank you for the preached word. We thank you for the prayers. We thank you for the fellowship. All that you have for us, oh God. God, we pray that you will bless those who are seeking Jesus Christ and those who want to be healed, those who want to be delivered. We accept them a part of the kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Pastor Pat, you're coming back? We're coming back? Amen. I think that's it on this morning. We thank you for joining us. We thank you for logging on. Listen, we're about to log off 10:30. Come on over to Purpose to Three Cross of Calvary online and join us again as we celebrate Pastor Donahue's 26th anniversary in ministry. Listen, there is no midweek Bible study this week. But there will be something for you to go back and view and watch a preached word. And then we'll come back on next Sunday again. Same place, Purpose Church online with the preached word. Listen, I love you. God bless you. Continue to walk in fellowship, walk in purpose. Reach out to somebody. Check on somebody today. Make sure they have what they need in Jesus' name. God bless you all.